Hi everyone, this session I am going to discuss about single phase of controlled rectifier fed DC separately excited motor. In the previous session we discussed about full controlled rectifier fed DC separately excited motor. What is the difference between off control and full control? In off control, the two thyristors will be replaced by diodes. In full control, all four switches are thyristors. In half control, the two thyristors will be replaced by diode D1 and D2. So that is the difference between half control and full control, right? So in the half control, by default we will get one more period called freewheeling period. Which avoids the negative cycle conduction. In the rectifier. So the D1, D2 will be much useful for the freewheeling action. Already we discussed, that is, by using the rectifier we can convert the input AC into DC. What's our objective? Our objective is to control the speed of DC motor. How to control the speed of DC motor? By controlling the armature voltage. How to control the armature voltage? By using a controlled rectifier, we can control the armature voltage. So here given AC supply will be converted into controlled DC voltage, and that DC voltage will be applied across the armature so that we can control the speed of DC motor. So in the previous session and all, we discussed during positive off cycle, the thyristor T1 and D1 will become forward biased and the current will start flow from VS plus, that is supply, plus T1, then motor, that is armature, then D1, after that VS minus. It will flow like that. Then at the end of off cycle, what will happen? The inductor will store some energy. So because of that, a magnetic field will get collapsed and it will induce an EMF. So during that time, what will happen? This inductor will act as the voltage source. So if it is acting as the voltage source, downside it will become plus, top side it will become minus. Since the downside is plus, more positive, diode D1 will become forward biased. And the top side it is negative, so the D2 will become forward biased. So the D1, D2 is on, it will make a short circuit across that armature. So the current will flow through the D1 and D2. So since it is short circuited, armature voltage becomes zero. So only the current will flow. How the current will flow? From the armature, that is from the motor, D1, D2, then again it will come to the motor, that is armature. So this period is called freewheeling period. So during freewheeling period, the armature voltage becomes zero because here we are short circuiting. Here it is getting short circuit. So armature voltage becomes zero, but the current will continuously flow through D1 and D2. Similarly, during negative off cycle, what happened? Downside it will become positive and the top side will become negative. So in this case, D2 and T2 will become forward biased. Now the current will start flow from VS plus D2 motor, that is armature, then T2, after that it will reach the minus. So during negative off cycle, this is the current flow that already we discussed in the previous sessions. Like a single phase fully controlled rectifier, here also we got two type of conductions. One is called a continuous conduction, another one is discontinuous conduction. What is continuous conduction? If the armature current flows continuously, then it is called a continuous current. Instead, if the armature current reaches zero and if it remains zero for some times, after that if it starts rising, then that is called a discontinuous current conduction. Here the armature current is not reaching zero, it is keep on flowing, so it is called a continuous conduction. So during continuous conduction, what will happen here? During positive off cycle, the T1, D1 will become forward biased and the current will start flow from VS plus T1, then armature, D1, then negative. at the end of the cycle, at the end of this pi period, then the input supply will start negative side. So here it will be, this will become negative and this will become positive. So during the time, the inductor voltage will switch, that is inductor will act as the voltage source, and it will become downside, it will become plus, and top side it will become minus. So in that case, what will happen, that D1 D2 will become forward bias. How it will become forward bias? This is positive and D1 will be connected with anode is connected with the positive, so D1 will become forward bias. Here the D2 negative cathode will be connected with the negative of the inductor supply, yeah, that is inductor. Now inductor will act as the voltage source, so then the negative is connected with the D2 cathode. So the both D1 and D2 will become forward biased, and the freewheeling action will take place. So during the freewheeling action, the voltage, armature voltage becomes zero, but the inductor starts releasing the energy. So if the inductor starts releasing the energy, then see from here, pi, what upon the current through the armature start decreasing, means that the inductor is releasing the energy, but the inductor, that is armature current, will not become zero. Before that only we will turn on the next pair. Well, next pair means we will turn, we will give the pulse to T2. So if we give pulse to T2, then the current will start flow from D2. Since we are giving over here, the D1 will become reverse biased, because in this case supply voltage become more compared with that inductor voltage. So the D1 will become reverse biased, and now the current will start flow from Vs plus D2 motor, then T2, then Vs minus. So again, what will happen, from pi plus, so from here pi plus duration to 2 pi, we will get the armature voltage. Then again, what will happen, that input supply will enter into the negative side. That input supply will end, actually here that input supply will start from the positive half cycle, next positive half cycle. So during this time, what will happen, inductor will again switch the voltage. So if the inductor switches the voltage, downside it will become positive, top side it will become negative. So D1, D2 will become forward bias, then again freewheeling action will take place. So again 2 pi, 2 pi to again 2 pi plus alpha, the voltage become, armature voltage become zero. So during this time, what will happen, that armature current will start decrease. So this is for the continuous current conduction. Therefore, by controlling the alpha value, we can control the output voltage. How? That we will see in the mathematical derivation. Here actually this is your armature voltage across the armature, and this is voltage, that is current flowing through the armature, IA. This is VA, this is IA, and this is all the waveform merged together. This is positive half cycle, this is converted negative half cycle, we will treat it as the positive half cycle. This is your input waveform. Then this is armature voltage. Then this one is armature current. So all the waveform we put together over here. Now we need to derive the magnitude, that is armature voltage. What is the value of armature voltage? For that we will consider only the armature voltage waveform, this waveform, armature voltage waveform we will consider. So here, what is the period is, we will take 0 to pi or alpha to pi. So now if we consider that alpha to pi, so the 1 by pi integration alpha to pi, so during alpha to pi the value is Vm sin omega t. So alpha to pi Vm sin omega t d omega t, Vm is constant, take outside. So alpha to pi sin omega t. Now sin omega t if you integrate, you will get a minus cos omega t. Limit is alpha to pi. Now substitute the top limit, that is cos pi minus, then the bottom limit cos alpha. Cos pi minus cos alpha. Cos pi value become minus 1, then minus cos alpha. That already we taken minus outside. If you multiply, then it will become 1 plus cos alpha. So Va equal to Vm by pi 1 plus cos alpha. Therefore, by controlling the alpha, we can control the armature voltage. By controlling the armature voltage, we can control the speed. So this is for continuous current conduction. Now we'll discuss about the discontinuous current conduction. In discontinuous current conduction, what will happen, that current value remains zero for some times, that is from beta to pi plus alpha, next cycle, beta to pi plus alpha, the current remains zero. So that is why it is called a discontinuous current conduction. So this mode is called a discontinuous current conduction. So in this mode, during positive half cycle, the current will start flow from plus T1 armature, D1 negative. Now during negative half cycle, what happens? The inductor will switch a shift polarity. That is, inductor will act as the voltage source. Downside it will become positive, and the top side it will become negative. So this is plus and this is minus. So the D1 D2 will become forward bias. Then the freewheeling action will take place through the D1 and D2, and inductor starts releasing the energy. Here the inductor will store very less amount of energy. The inductor value is less, so it will store the less amount of energy so that it will release the energy quickly through the D1 and D2 under the closed circuit. So inductor will release the energy. So up to here the inductor is storing that energy, so the IA value will be rising. After that inductor is releasing that energy, so the IA value will start decreasing, and soon it will reach the zero at beta. After that, since it is reaching the zero, there will be no conduction because there is no energy to dissipate, so there is no voltage, so it will become zero. The voltage value become zero. Since here then there is no conduction, these two will become open circuit. If these two become open circuit, then the voltage available across the armature become only the E value. So that is why during beta to next cycle conduction, that is pi plus alpha, we will get only the value of E. Only the value of E. So from alpha to pi, we will get a Vm sin omega t. Then pi to beta, we will get 0. Then beta to pi plus alpha, the voltage across the armature will be only the E. Similar is the case for negative half cycle. Now, what is the voltage available across the armature? Voltage available across the armature is 1 by pi. So here we will consider only the armature voltage. So this is your armature voltage, and this is armature current waveform. This is all put together waveform. Armature voltage, then the armature current, then input reference also we taken, and this is the E, this EMF, this E value we consider. Now, if we consider the armature voltage, that is nothing but 1 by pi from alpha, where from here actually, the alpha value will be here. From alpha to pi, we got a Vm sin omega t. Alpha to pi, we got Vm sin omega t. Actually, the alpha value will be here, alpha. This is alpha to pi, Vm sin omega t. Then this beta, beta to here, pi plus alpha. Beta to pi plus alpha, we get a E d omega t. E, that is E we will be getting, so that we are under with respect to the d omega t. So Vm is constant, take outside, we will get a alpha to pi sin omega t. Here E is constant, take outside, d omega t. Sin omega t if integrate, minus cos omega t. D omega t if integrate, you will get a omega t. Now if you substitute the limit, it will become cos pi minus cos alpha, E pi plus alpha minus beta. Then cos pi value is minus 1. If you substitute and if you rearrange it, then we will get Va equal to 1 by pi Vm 1 plus cos alpha plus E pi plus alpha minus beta. So this is for discontinuous current conduction. This is for the discontinuous current conduction operation. So by controlling that alpha value, firing angle value, we can control the armature voltage. By controlling the armature voltage, we can control the speed of separately excited DC motor. So I hope in this session you would have understand, you would have got the operation of single phase off controlled rectifier fed DC motor. If you have any doubt, mail to me.